Good evening. The State Television Company of Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. The Constitution of Western Armenia. Today is Triple Holiday. 28 years ago, Shushi was liberated. Number of coronavirus cases in Armenia grows by 146 in past 24 hours. The Granakert Historic Delivery Bridge is awaiting renovation. 4 years after its declaration, the Constitution of Western Armenia is now a real instrument which strengthens human rights and the rights of indigenous people. What was impossible a few years ago changes reality. This effectively shows that the will of people can overcome immeasurable difficulties in achieving a new meaning for their history by preparing their future and re-establishing an earlier reality. Thus, the Constitution of Western Armenia is not based on the post-genocide, but rather on the concept of Armenity. In this way, it transcends a victimological vision to highlight the fact that the Armenian people have a value for humanity, regardless of the existence of the historical genocide. In this sense, it is a constitution of an indigenous people who assert their nature without fear because they participated in drafting of the Declaration of the Rights of Indigenous People, recognized by the United Nations in 2007. This constitution already has a past charged with history, which represents an added value. Thus, this anniversary shows that there is a path to follow which leads to the liberation of people and their ancestral territory via a legal approach on the one hand and a strategic approach on the other hand, while relying on international law. Nikos Ligeris, President of the Constitutional Council of the Republic of Western Armenia. On May 9, the Armenian people celebrate the Triple Holiday, the 75th anniversary of the victory in the Great Patriotic War, the anniversary of the liberation of Shushi, and the establishment of the Artsakh Defense Army. On this day, events are planned in Armenia and Artsakh, which however will not be of a mass nature, in order to prevent the spread of a new type of coronavirus infection. In Armenia and Artsakh, tribute will be paid to the memory of the victorious and immortal heroes, as well as the war veterans. From the morning of May 9, events will take place in Yerevan's Victory Park, Stepanakert, and Shushi. Rest will be laid at the monument to Commander Vazgen Sarkisyan in Shushi. The Prime Minister of the Republic of Armenia, Nikol Pashinyan, will visit Artsakh. 28 years ago, on May 8, the Armenian Armed Forces liberated Shushi. The liberation of Shushi was a turning point in Artsakh war. It was from here that Azeris struck in the direction of Stepanakert and nearby villages. Despite the overwhelming strength of enemy and thanks to the courage and brilliant fighting spirit of Armenian heroes, Shushi was finally liberated on May 9, which allowed them to return to their homeland and move forward. The operation was carried out in four directions with simultaneous attacks on the night of May 8 at 2:30 a.m. after capturing the Kyrgyz military position and taking control of the Lachin-Shushi road. The military operation was led by commander of the self-defense forces Arkady Dertadevosyan. The military operation to liberate Shushi is almost perfect in terms of development and implementation, a unique military operation in Armenian martial arts, which caused a radical breakthrough in Artsakh liberation war. It lasted 26 hours and on May 9 Shushi was liberated. The number of coronavirus cases in Armenia grew by 146 in the past 24 hours, reaching 3,029. The Center for Control and Prevention of Diseases reports, according to the center, a total of 1,267 patients have recovered. 1,852 are getting treatment. The coronavirus death toll reached 40. 12 coronavirus patients died from other illnesses. About 30 kilometers from the Chinar province is the historic Dilaver Bridge, which is estimated to be 400 years old. Residents of the area expressed their concern over the danger of collapse of the bridge. They demanded that the authorities take care of the bridge, which could collapse at any moment. Residents note that if this historic structure with its beauty is not repaired very quickly, it will be completely destroyed. Now let us represent your attention a song by Karin Ensemble. The whole version of the song in the official page of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.